Welcome to Monday Morning Quarterback, a weekly feature of Canon Church. I'm Tim Emmett, the senior pastor at Canon, and on Monday mornings, we connect the message from Sunday, the game of football, and the week ahead. It's remembered as the catch, just the catch. On January 20th, 1982, the San Francisco 49ers and Dallas Cowboys played each other in the NFC Championship game. Late in the fourth quarter, with 58 seconds left, the 49ers were down by six, had the ball on the Cowboys' six-yard line, third and three. Joe Montana, the 49ers quarterback, took the snap, rolled to his right, looked, no one was open. With three Cowboys defenders bearing down on him, he pump faked and then threw the ball high toward the back of the end zone. It looked like he was throwing the football away, but then Dwight Clark, a 6'4" receiver for the 49ers, leaped high as he could, managed to grab the ball with his fingertips, came down in the end zone, touchdown. That reception, that play, that touchdown is remembered as the catch, not just because it won that game for the 49ers, but because that catch won that game, which turned out to be a changing of the guard. It signaled the end of one era and the beginning of another. Since its founding in 1970, the NFC had been dominated by the Cowboys. They were the team of the 70s in the NFC. But in the 80s, it was the 49ers. They were the team, not just of the NFC, but of the NFL. The catch won that championship game, sent the 49ers to their first Super Bowl, which they won, the first of four Super Bowls, which they would win in the 80s. That one catch marked the ending of one dynasty and the beginning of another. Yesterday morning, we continued our sermon series, Let There Be Joy. It's a celebration of the resurrection of Jesus. And I preached on Let There Be Faith. And we talked about how faith was raised when Christ rose. Faith, not just that Jesus was raised bodily from the grave, but faith that the crucified Jesus now reigns over all, that the world revolves around love, that love rules over this world. Not power, but love. The resurrection of Jesus marked a changing of the guard, the end of one dominion, the dominion of power, the beginning of another, the dominion of love. That's the good news of Easter. That's the faith that was raised when Christ rose. So what's the game plan for the week? Pray the Jesus Creed. What's that? Well, when Jesus was asked, what's the most important commandment in the scriptures? He replied, the most important is, hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord your God with all of your heart, soul, mind, and strength. But then Jesus added, the second is this, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. Those two commandments, love God, love others, that's the Jesus Creed. You might this week revive an ancient practice, remembering, praying those two commandments, the words of Jesus at the beginning and ending of every day. If love rules the world, if the world now revolves around love because the crucified Jesus sits at the right hand of God and rules over all, then beginning and ending each day with those two commandments, praying the Jesus Creed is a way to center ourselves on what really matters and who really rules. That's the game plan for this week. Pray the Jesus Creed. I hope you have a great week.